Good afternoon. We are going to begin exercise 19D. In this exercise, we will be learning about the method of finding the coordinate of point of intersection of the two line. And this concept we have already studied in class 10 in the linear equation chapter, linear equation in two variable, where we calculated the value of x and y by two different methods. You may remember, the first method was substitution method, then comparison method, and then the last was elimination method. So we can use any one of these three methods and we can find the coordinate of the point of intersection of the two lines. So this exercise is going to be simple for you, but we will have a more calculation, number one. Number two, we will have also the application of this concept. We will have also the application part, and application part will be a bit lengthy. So we need to have some patience and then we can enjoy this exercise. So with this, we are going to start question number one. Look at question number one. This question number one is to find the coordinate of the point of intersections of the straight lines. So here we are given two straight lines by means of linear equation. Now the question is to find the coordinate of the point of intersection of the two lines. Hope the question is very clear. So we are going to begin the question. The two equations we are going to solve. The first part, question number A of question number 1. Clear? So, the first equation is 3x minus 5y is equal plus 5 plus 5 is equal to 0. And then another equation we have is 2x plus 3y plus minus 22 is equal to 0. So this is the linear equation, right? This is pair of linear equation. We will solve it by elimination method. Okay. Now we can name this first equation as equation number 1 and this as equation number 2. Now we have to decide. We have to select by ourselves. There is no hard and fast rule. The choice is all yours. You want to eliminate x or you want to eliminate y. You have to do the selection. Is it okay? So whatever you select to eliminate, you have to make their coefficient same. Suppose if I want to make the coefficient of x same, if I want to eliminate x, that means I have to make their coefficient same. And this I can do by finding the LCM of the coefficient 2 and 3. And this we can do by multiplication. You have already studied this in class 10. I am going to select this y. My plan is to eliminate y. The reason why I am eliminating y is my own choice. Otherwise, I can say that one is positive, another is negative. So, for eliminating this, I don't have to go for subtraction. For that reason, I am selecting y. But if I want to go for subtraction, I can even choose this x. Alright, so choice is yours. So, I said I will eliminate y. So, I need to make the coefficient of these two y same. This is 5, this is 3, and the LCM of these two is 15. That means this should be 15 and this should also be 15. To make this 15, we will multiply the first equation by 3. And to make this 15, we will multiply this equation by 5. This is very clear. Now the first equation will change to, we'll multiply each and every term by 3. So 3 is a 9x minus 15y plus 15 is equal to 0. And third equation, second equation will become 10x plus 15y and then minus 110 is equal to 0. Since we are doing addition here, because the sign is already different, therefore we don't need to do subtraction. So we don't need to change the sign. Is it okay? Some students, they think that always we have to change the sign. It's not necessary, it depends. If you are doing subtraction, only then the sign of this down line will change. Otherwise, it remains as it is. And then this gets cancelled. So this is becoming 19x. And this will become how much? This will become 95 is equal to 0. This will be negative 95 because this magnitude is more and it is negative. So this is negative. Now, 19x is equal to 95, right? So your x will become equal to 95 divided by 19. So your x is equal to 95 is 95. So this is your value of x. After calculating x, by eliminating y, we calculated x. Now this x can be substituted either in equation number 1 or in equation number 2, right? And we can calculate the value of y. So substituting value of x in equation 1. I'm going to substitute this value in 1. So 3, and for x we will put 5. So 5 minus 5y plus 5 is equal to 0. Right? This is 15 minus 5y plus 5 is equal to 0. This minus 5y I will take to that side, and 15 plus 5 will be added. So this becomes 5y is equal to 20, and therefore y is equal to 20 over 5, and your answer is 4. Is it understood? So by solving the pair of linear equations by elimination method, we calculated the coordinate of the point of intersection. This value of x and y gives you the coordinate of the point of intersection of the two lines. That means these two lines are going to intersect somewhere, and the coordinate of that point of intersection is x is 5 and y is 4. Therefore, the required coordinate or the coordinate of the point of intersection, coordinate of point of intersection of the two line is what? Is x is 5 and y is 4. That's all. So this was the first question, and it was a very simple question. I did A part, and then B part you will do as your assignment. So this was the very simplest question. But the next question here we are going to see is the application of this method. Okay, application of the algebraic method of solving the pair of linear equation. By applying it, we are going to do some other calculations also. So those will be little lengthy. Is it alright? Thank you. Now the next question, we are moving on to question number 2. Look at the question number 2. Find the area of the triangle formed by the lines so and so and so. Find the area of the triangle formed by the lines so and so and so. So there are 3 equations given for the 3 sides. So using these 3 equations of the 3 sides of a triangle, we have to find out the area. So let us see how can we do this question. This is solution of question number 2. First of all, let me draw the diagram. This is the triangle, and we have the equations for these 3 sides. Let me name this triangle as A, B and C, right? And then we have the 3 equations. So each equation is for one side. So we will write down x plus y minus 6 is equal to 0. X plus y minus 6 is equal to 0. The first equation is not written in alphabetical order, so I did the arrangement. Don't think that this equation is different. Another one is negative x plus 3y and then plus 2 is equal to 0. Negative x plus 3y plus 2 is equal to 0. And the last equation is 3y is equal to 5x plus 2. So we have these 3 equations. We have these 3 sides. And the question is to find out the area of the triangle. So in order to find the area of the triangle, right, what we need is the coordinate of the vertex. If we can calculate the coordinate of the 3 vertices, then we can use the matrix method formula and find out the area of the triangle. Am I understood? So we need, now this question is going to be lengthy. This is because you can see here, you can solve this pair of equation and then find, you can get the coordinate for B. By solving these two equations, you will get the point of intersection of these two equations, and the point of intersection of these two lines is this point B. So you will be able to get the coordinate of point B by solving this pair of linear equation. Clear? Then you have to solve this pair of linear equation, you will get the coordinate of this point of intersection. And then finally, you can solve this pair of linear equation and you will get the coordinate of point C. So that is why I said that this question is quite lengthy, because you have to solve these equations for three times. Is it okay? So therefore, just be very vigilant. We are going to first of all find out the coordinate of, say, A. Coordinate of A we are going to calculate. Is it okay? Coordinate of A. So let us solve this two pair of equation. So first equation is x plus y minus 6 is equal to 0. Is it okay? And this equation also, if you want to write in the same way, you can do that. So let us write this equation also in the same manner. 5x minus 3y plus 2 is equal to 0. Now we can name this as equation number 1, this is equation number 2. While rearranging the terms, you have to be very careful, mindful for the transposing the term from one side to another side. Now we can solve it. So now you have to select which variable you are going to eliminate. I am choosing this y. So in order to choose this y, I have to have their coefficient same. So the LCM of this y coefficient 1 and then this y coefficient minus 3 will be 3. So ultimately, I just need to multiply this equation only by 3, because this is already 3, we don't need to do any changes. Let us see now, first equation will change to 3x plus 3y minus 9 is equal to, minus 18, 6 3 is 18 is equal to 0. Clear? Now I can simplify here itself, and then this is cancelled, this becomes 8x and this becomes minus 16 is equal to 0. Now you simplify, this is 8x is equal to 16, and this implies your x will be equal to 16 divided by 8 is equal to 2. So for this point, we got the coordinate of x, and this is as 2. Alright, now we are going to put this value in 1 or in 2, anywhere. 1 is more easy, so let us put it in 1. Now, substituting value of x in equation 1. So it becomes what? For x we can write 2. So 2 plus y minus 6 is equal to 0. This implies your y minus 4 is equal to 0, because 2 and minus 6 is minus 4, and therefore your y is equal to 4. So you got the coordinate of y also for this point. So for this vertex, we got the value of x and y, we got the coordinate of point of intersection of A. Am I very clear? Now we will calculate the coordinate for B. Now coordinate of B. Coordinate of B, the first equation we have is x plus y minus 6 is equal to 0. Then another equation is minus x plus 3y plus 2 is equal to 0. This is equation number 1, this is equation number 2. Now in this equation, in this part, you can see here the coefficient of x is already same. That means we need not to do that step, the first step. First step we can skip, because already the coefficient of x is equal. And we don't need to do subtraction also, because one is already positive and one is negative. So directly we are in a position to eliminate x, and therefore x is eliminated. Finally, this is 4y, and this becomes also minus 4 is equal to 0. And therefore your y is equal to, this 4 goes to that side and this 4 will come down. So your value of y is equal to 1. Is this okay? So for this point, we got the value of y, and that is equal to 1. Now by putting this value of y in 1 or in 2, we can get the value of x. So substituting value of y in equation 1. So your x plus y is calculated 1 minus 6 is equal to 0. Therefore, this implies your x minus 5 is equal to 0, and so your x is equal to 5. So we got the value of x also for the point B. Am I very clear or not? Now, what we can do is, we need to find the coordinate of point C. We need to find the coordinate of point C. For this, I need to have some space, and therefore I am going to clean this part, so that we can find the coordinate of point C. Is this okay? And for finding the coordinate of C, we need to have the equation of side AC and the equation of side BC. Is it all right? So, let us have this equation. Now we are going to find the coordinate of C. This is coordinate of B. This is coordinate of B. Anyway, I will write this with a different color. Coordinate of C. For this, we need to have this equation. Minus x plus 3y plus 2 is equal to 0. Is it okay? And this equation we will write in the alphabetical order. We will write this as 5x minus 3y and plus 2 is equal to 0. Is it okay? Now this we will name as equation number 1, this as equation number 2. Now here the coefficient of y is already same, so we don't need to think about x. We can directly eliminate because 1 is positive, 1 is negative, so cancel. So this becomes 4x, and this becomes plus 4 is equal to 0, and therefore this implies your x is equal to 1, sorry, minus 1, because this 4 will go to the other side, will become minus 4, and this 4 comes down, so plus, minus 4 over 4 will become minus 1. Alright, now we can find the value of y. So we can put it in any of the equation. I am going to put it in equation number 1. So putting the value of x in equation 1. So what happens? This is minus, and then your x is also minus. So minus 1 plus 3y and plus 2 is equal to 0. So this minus minus will become plus. So this is plus 1 and this is plus 2. So this is plus 3. Plus 1 plus 2 plus 3. This is 3y plus 3 is equal to 0. This implies your 3y is equal to minus 3, and therefore your y is equal to minus 3 divided by 3 is equal to minus 1. So finally we calculated the value of coordinate of C also, and though that value is x is minus 1 and y also is minus 1. Is it okay? Please remember that what we are doing, we are asked to calculate the area of this triangle when the name of the three sides are given, when the equations of the three sides are given. So using the elimination method, by solving it algebraically, we try to calculate the coordinate of A, B and C. Now after this, we are in a position to use the matrix method to find the area of this triangle. So now we are going to find the area of this triangle. So to find the area, what we will do is, first of all, we will have this in a matrix form. So I'm going to start with A, the coordinate. The first coordinate is 2 and 4. We will write in the column form. B is 5 and 1. C coordinate is minus 1 and minus 1. If you remember the matrix method, we used to write the coordinate of all the points this way. Since here we have triangle and there are three pair of coordinates, so we wrote three pair of coordinate. And for finding the area, at the end we will repeat the first order pair. So this is 2 and 4. Is this very clear? So this is all our four ordered pair, right? So the number of row is used to be one more than the number of vertices. Now we are going to find the area of the triangle. Area of triangle ABC. Okay, so half of mod of, right? 2 into 1 minus 5 into 4, 2 into 1 minus 5 into 4 plus 5 into minus 1 and then minus this into this. So 5 into minus 1 minus minus 1 into 1. Is this clear? And third one is minus 1 into 4 plus minus 1 into 4 minus 2 into minus 1. Now let us operate. This writing is clear because already we have done this concept in the previous matrix chapter. So in the connectivity chapter only, half of 2 into 2 minus 20 plus minus 5 and then this will become plus. So plus 1 into 1 plus 1 and then last is minus 4 and then plus 2. This is half of, this is minus 18, this will be minus 4, this will be minus 2. So half 18 4 22 22 to 24. So this is mod of 24. This is mod, magnitude of absolute value sign. That means the meaning of this absolute value is when you remove this, the sign also will disappear because the number will come out signless. So this becomes half into 24 and therefore the answer is 12 square unit or unit square is the area of your this triangle. So you have seen one of the application of the algebraic method of solving the pair of linear equation. With this we calculated also the area of that triangle. Clear? Thank you. Now the next question is question number 3. Question number 3, it talks about orthocenter. It talks about orthocenter. Orthocenter, what we have to do here is, we are asked to find the coordinate. We are asked to find the orthocenter of the triangle. Means, we are asked to find the coordinate of the orthocenter of the triangle whose angular points are given so and so and so. Angular point means the coordinate of the vertices. Angular point means coordinate of the vertices. So the information we have in this question is the coordinate of the three vertices. We are given the coordinate of the three vertices and with the help of the coordinate of these three vertices, we have to find the coordinate of orthocenter. Coordinate of orthocenter. So first of all, we will try to understand. Already you know, some of you might be knowing because you have studied this in class 10, the orthocenter. Okay, orthocenter is the point of intersection of the three altitudes. Orthocenter is what? Is the point of intersection of the altitude. Clear? So first thing is also orthocenter. And I told you that orthocenter is the point of intersection of the three altitude. Now, what is altitude? Altitude is the perpendicular drawn from a vertex to the opposite side. Right? Perpendicular drawn from a vertex to the opposite side is called as altitude. And because there are three sides, there are three vertices, therefore there will be three altitudes. And these all the three altitudes used to intersect at one point. And that point of intersection of the three altitude is called as orthocenter. So let me show you by means of the diagram. This is your triangle. This is your triangle. We don't have the name of this triangle in our book. So, what we can do is, we will name the three vertices. First of all, for our own convenience, we will say this is A, this is B, and this is C. Am I understood? So, now, we need to have the coordinate of all the three vertices. So, the coordinate of A is 0, 0. Coordinate of A is 0, 0. Coordinate of B is 2, negative 1 and coordinate of C is negative 1 and 3. Negative 1 and 3. Is it okay? So, we have have the coordinate of the, we have this triangle, and then the whose coordinates are given. These are called, these points are called as the angular point, because at this point we have the angle. Therefore, these vertices are also called as the angular points. Am I clear? Now we are asked to calculate the coordinate of the orthocenter. So let us see. From this point, I can drop a perpendicular onto opposite side. And opposite side to A is BC. So from here, you draw a perpendicular. This is the perpendicular to the side BC. This is perpendicular, so I can put this notation, right? This is your altitude. From this B also, we can draw the altitude to the opposite side AC. And then there will be the third altitude on the other side from vertex C. Clear? So this is another one. This is also altitude. Clear? Let me name this point as, this is D. This is D. Alphabetically, I am taking, this is E and this is F. Right? So you know that this is called as altitude. Altitude means a perpendicular drawn from the vertex to the opposite side is called as altitude. So there are three altitudes, and all these three altitudes are intersecting at one point, and this point is called as the orthocenter. Let us denote it by O. Here the question is to find the coordinate of this point O, that is the value of X and Y. So this is your main question. This is very important, first of all, to understand the question. So in this question, we have the term called orthocenter. So I try to explain you what is orthocenter. And then a term which is related to the orthocenter is the altitude. So I also explained you what is altitude. After having the good concept, clear concept of orthocenter and the altitude, we are now going to see how can we calculate the coordinate of the orthocenter. Is this very clear? So first of all, before I solve this question, I will tell you the step. Is this okay? So first thing that we will do is, the working rule, this is just to make you very clear about the step, because this question also will be lengthy, right? So here if I write this working rule, then you will know that how you have to find out the coordinate of the orthocenter step by step. So step number one is, you need to calculate the slope of all the three sides of the triangle. Calculate the slope of sides of the triangle. Calculate the slope of the sides of the triangle. And for calculating the slope of the sides of the triangle, because we have the coordinates, so we can use the formula M is equal to y2 minus y1. You already know how to find the slope with the two points x2 minus x1. Using this formula, we will be able to calculate the slope of all the points. Is this okay? Now, I will show you roughly. Okay. When we calculate the slope of AB, right? One example. AB, right? Using this formula, I can say this is x1, y1, and this is x2, y2. This is x1, y1, this is x2, y2. That means minus 1, minus 0 is minus 1. And then denominator y2 minus x2 minus x1. So 2 minus 0. 2 minus 0, that means 2. Therefore, the slope of this side is minus half. Am I understood or not? So likewise, I will be showing you to calculate the slope of BC and the slope of AC. So the first thing that we are going to do is, we are going to find the slope of all the three sides. Clear? And after finding the slope of the three sides, then number two, after the slope of all the three sides are calculated, then we will calculate the slope of altitude. I will solve this question, right? But then first of all, I am just giving you explanation. I am trying to explain you, because the question is lengthy. Now see here, what we have done in step number one is we calculated the slope of, this is just one example, right? So we have calculated the slope of side AB, right? This is the slope of side AB. After the slope is calculated, then we will calculate the slope of the altitude. So the perpendicular, altitude means perpendicular. So since now we know the slope of this one, so we can find the slope of this perpendicular. You know what is the perpendicular line condition for the slope? The slope of the perpendicular lines are a negative reciprocal of each other, right? So if this is M1, then this M2 will be, that is M2 is the slope of your CD. This will be the negative reciprocal of this one. So first of all, write the reciprocal of this and then change the sign. So it becomes 2. Am I understood? So now this is the second step. First step is, you calculated the slope of the side. You will calculate the slope of the side. Step number two is, then you will calculate the slope of your altitude. And then the slope, and the third step is, write the equation of the altitude. Third step is, step number three is, write equation of altitude. If the working rule is clear, then you will not have any problem and you will be able to do the question smoothly. Am I clear? So write equation of the altitude. So now we will be writing the equation for this altitude. I summarize the topic. Once again, I will repeat the whole process. Step number one, calculate the coordinate of, calculate the slope of AB. Step number two, then calculate the slope of the altitude. Step number three is, now write the equation. So for writing the equation, what you will use? You have calculated the slope of your this line, and for this line you have a coordinate of 1 point also. So using what you will, which method you will use? 1 point, 1 point, and slope formula. And slope formula. Am I understood? So third part, we have calculated the equation of this line. Is it okay? Your question is to find the coordinate of the ortho center. To find the coordinate of the ortho center. Is this okay? What you have to do is, for two sides we will calculate the slope. So I calculated for this one. Along with this, you can also calculate the slope of this one. Am I clear? So we will only calculate for two sides. We don't need to calculate for all the three sides. Only for two sides you can calculate, right? What will happen is, you calculated for this side, then you got this altitude and you got the equation. Number three step. You calculated the slope, step number one. You calculated the slope of the altitude, step number two. Then you wrote the equation of altitude, step number three. Done. Now go to the another side. For the other side, again you find out the slope, then find out the slope of this altitude, step number two, and then write down the equation of this, altitude. That way, ultimately at the end, you will have the equation for the two altitude. You got this equation for this altitude, and you got the equation for this altitude. After you calculated the equation for this altitude and calculated the equation for this altitude, you can solve this pair of equation by algebraic method, and you will get the coordinate of the point of intersection. That's all. Is this okay? So now I'm going to actually show. So these are three steps in which you will solve the question. And then step number four is, solve pair of equation to find coordinate of ortho center. Is it all right? So solve pair of equation. One equation you will get for this altitude, another equation you will get for this altitude, and then you are solving it to get the coordinate of point O. Clear? So after this, now we are going to solve this question, begin this question. We are going to start with side AB. So first of all, slope of side AB, right? Use the formula is M is equal to y2 minus y1, that is minus 1 minus 0 over x2 minus x1, 2 minus 0. So this is minus half. This is the slope of AB, step number 1. Step number 2, now slope of CD. Slope of CD, and CD is what? Altitude, which will be negative reciprocal of this one. So minus 1 over minus 1 over 2. Minus minus cancel, this number will go upside down. Answer is 2. Done? Now next what? Now we will write the equation for this altitude. Equation of altitude CD, right? So M of this is, formula is M is equal to y minus y1 over x minus x1. Is it okay? So M is 2 is equal to y minus y1, that is negative 3 over x minus minus 1. Is it okay? Is equal to y minus 3 over x plus 1. Now cross multiplication. So 2 into x, 2x plus 2 ones are 2 is equal to y minus 3. 2 into x and 2 into 1, 2. This is 2x minus y is equal to, 2 will go to that side, will become minus 5, minus 2 and minus 3 is minus 5. This is your equation number 1. So step number 1, step number 2 and step number 3 done. Fourth step we will do only after the equation of this also, after the equation of one more altitude is calculated. So now we are going to calculate the same three things for the other altitude AE. So we will go with side BC. So slope of BC, of side BC, this is M is equal to y2 minus y1, 3 minus minus 1 over x2 minus x1, 1 minus 1 minus 2. So this is 4 over minus 3. Now we can find the altitude slope. Slope of altitude, slope of AE, and this AE is what? Altitude. This will be negative reciprocal of this one. Negative 1 over negative 4 over 3. This negative negative cancel. This is again 3 over 4. So we calculated the slope of this AE. Now we can have the equation of the altitude AE. Equation of altitude AE. Okay. So formula is the same again. Slope is 3 over 4 is equal to, now y minus y1, x minus x1. So this is equal to y over x, cross multiplication. And then if you can write the equation, 3x is equal to 4y, and this implies your equation is 3x minus 4y is equal to 0. This is your equation number 2. So for the another altitude also we calculated the 3 step. So now we are ready with the 2 equation. We will solve this pair of linear equation and we can find the coordinate of the ortho center. So this was our final equation. We are going to solve it. Now, I'm going to make the coefficient of y same. Therefore, I will multiply it by 4. So this equation number 1 will reduce to 4 to the 8x minus 4y is equal to minus 20. Right? 4 to the 8x, 4y is a 4, and 4, 5 is a 20. Now, changing the sign, because their signs are same. So this is positive. Now this is cancelled. So this is becoming 5x, and this is equal to 20 implies x is equal to 20 over minus 5 is equal to minus 4. We got x is equal to minus 4. Now we can put the value of this x in 1 or in 2, and we can find the value of y. Clear? So we are going to put it in equation number 1. Putting value of x in equation 1. So 2 into x, that is minus 4, minus y is equal to minus 5. So this is minus 8. This is minus y is equal to minus 5. Minus y this side, this minus 8. This is minus 5, and this minus 8 goes to that side will become plus 8. This will become plus 3. And minus sign will be sent to right hand side. So y is equal to minus 3. And therefore, required coordinate of orthocenter is x is equal to negative 4 and y is equal to negative 3. This is your answer. Hope you are able to understand the content. So with this, we are ending the session here itself. Thank you so much for watching the video. Enjoy learning us. Take care and stay safe.